Confirm.
And Kim, you get your full 10 minutes, okay?
Thank you so much. You ready to go?
I'm gripping and ripping.
Okay, here we go. Well, Dan Buettner helps Americans live longer, happier, healthier lives. He's done it through really studying the blue zones, and his book, The Blue Zone Secrets for Living Longer, Lessons from the Healthiest Places on Earth. Thanks so much for talking with me here today.
It's a delight to be here.
See, I wanted to do a Zoom interview with you because, you know, when you're talking about health, it's helpful to see somebody who looks healthy, right? Right?
Well, I ate my beans for breakfast, so I'm exuding good health.
See, just like in Israel.
And I mean energetically wise, by the way.
For sure, for sure. Now, the blue zones, for people that don't know, it's five places. I think you discovered another one too, right?
Well, a blue zone 2.0, but the big idea here, instead of trying to find a secret to longevity in Petri dish or test tube, we work with demographers over at National Geographic, and we found these five areas where people are living the longest. And it's not because they have better genes. Only 20% of how long we live is dictated by our genes. It's because they're eluding the diseases that are foreshortening our lives. They're not getting diabetes or heart disease or dementia anywhere near the rates that Americans are. And then by identifying the common denominators, it gives us a pretty good a direction for what we ought to be doing if we also want an extra decade.
And, you know, we were meant to eat real food. That's how our bodies were meant to operate, right?
And most of, you know, over 70% of all food in grocery stores is processed. Our body doesn't know what to do with, you know, when we eat an artificial sweetener, an artificial fat or flavor enhancer, it tricks our body. And it tells our body to do things our body is not meant to do with that food. If you do it once in a while, no big deal, but the sort of chronic eating of the standard American diet, you know, kills 660,000 Americans every year prematurely. More people have died eating the American diet than have died in all wars since the Civil War. And, you know, yet there's not a food administration to keep people healthy. In blue zones, we see very clearly when you're eating a whole food plant-based diet, greens and nuts and grains and tubers and beans, you're adding 10 to 13 extra years of life expectancy, depending on your age.
You know, we know what I wanted you to tell me about, because in researching this, you have this new thing that kind of you discovered, you know, relationships with people were always very important, right? Connections with family, with friends, with your community, but romantic partnerships, it's a recurrent feature now that's kind of, that you're seeing, right? With the longest living people.
Yeah. So if you can manage to stay with your partner, this is statistically speaking, I know there's exceptions, but If you're married or in a committed relationship, it's worth somewhere between 4 and 6 extra years of life expectancy as compared with being divorced or widowed or on your own. And by the way, the effect is especially strong for men. Women are much better for men when it comes to longevity than the other way around.
Ooh, that's good.
In fact, men who marry women 15 years younger than them I live about 11 years longer, and it doesn't work in reverse.
I like that. I like that. I like what you're saying there. what about chronic stress?
It's good for me.
What was that?
I said, well, it's good for me anyway.
Yeah, for sure. What about chronic stress? Because a friend of mine and I were talking about this recently. I had colon cancer. He had cancer. We both say that we feel that stress contributed to this greatly. Is there any studies that have been done on that?
Well, the root of every age-related disease, whether it's Alzheimer's, cancer, heart disease, is chronic inflammation. And what triggers inflammation is stress. When you're in a hurry or you're worried or anxious or frazzled, it releases cortisol, which triggers inflammation, And when that is triggered over and over and over again all the time, it's like a smoldering fire that inflames your arteries. It wrinkles your skin. It shrinks your brain. It's really caustic. And people in blue zones, they suffer the same stress as we do. They worry about their kids and their health. But what they have are sacred daily rituals to unwind that stress. The Adventists have prayer. The Okinawans have ancestor veneration, a few minutes where they're thinking of their ancestors rather than, you know, worrying about them being alone in the universe. The Costa Ricans and the Icarians take a nap, and the Sardinians do happy hour. But they all work at lowering that cortisol, the stress, and then the ensuing inflammation. And that's just something we should keep in mind.
Yeah. And, you know, it was so interesting going through all the different foods that some of the different people live, depending on where their homes are. What are some of the top longevity foods that we can eat that actually do good for our body?
Yeah. So the longest lived women in the history of the world come from Okinawa, Japan. And until about 1980, so most of a centenarian's life, two-thirds of their dietary intake came from purple sweet potatoes, close cousin to our sweet potatoes. But, you know, I can't tell you exactly. It may be the beta carotene or the antioxidant or the complex carbohydrates, but eating purple sweet potatoes in general is a very good idea. Turmeric, we also see in Okinawa. Tofu in Okinawa, they eat about 8 times more tofu. I argue the greatest diet in the history of humankind consists of 3 simple food. It's called the Three Sisters. It's squash, beans, and corn. Mm. And when you mix those 3 foods, you get all the amino acids necessary for human sustenance. It's complex, slow-burn carbohydrates. And it's fueled the longest lived people in the Americas, the Costa Ricans and the Nicoya. About 80% of their diet are those 3 foods, traditionally speaking. So, you know, you take it instead of trying to invent some new, you know, garbage superfood out there. And I guarantee you, if it says superfood, it almost never is. It's right. Always some sugar and concoction. It's better just to look at what people who've actually lived a long time, look at what they ate. Pay attention to it and bring that back to life in your home. I've tried to do that with the Blue Zones Kitchen in this latest book, but there's lots of great books that show you how to make whole plant-based food taste delicious.
Yeah, and we can't forget about exercise. This summer, like, I decided I'm cracking down, and I'm like swimming 4 to 6 hours a day, and eating the right food.
You look very clean.
Yeah, thank you for saying that, because I feel really clean. Like, I look different than I did last time we spoke, right?
You do, yes. And you're younger. But excuse me, I've been talking my head off here for all morning. But, you know, counterintuitively, though, I will say that exercise doesn't really work. You know, fewer than 23% of Americans get the minimum 20 minutes of physical activity a day. Well, the 23%, that means 77%, they're not even getting that. In blue zones, everybody walks 8,000 steps or more. Why? Yeah. Because they live in communities that are walkable. And every time they go to work or a friend's house or out to eat, they're doing so on their feet. And, you know, until kind of American and city planners wake up and smell the cappuccino, we're not going to beat this sedentary problem we have in our country until we change our environment. It's much better if you want to get healthier, instead of trying to change your behavior, which almost never lasts, change your environment.
Yeah. As someone told me, 80% food, 20% exercise. I'm doing it to get strong, you know, to be able to build muscle and get strong. You know what was disappointing when I saw it in the book, and is there any other, I love the protein source as eggs, right? But eggs aren't that great for you, right?
Well, if you look at all the research, half the papers say they're bad for you, half the papers say they're good for you. In blue zones, people are eating about 3 eggs a week, which is probably a safe level. But remember, their eggs are pasture raised. You know, there's one brand here in America, Vital Farms. They make a pretty good egg, and three or so a week. It's probably the right amount. But you can get as much protein as is in an egg and just a third a cup of lentils. Mm. So I start my day eating a three bean minestrone, which I make. The recipe's in the book, I believe. And that's what the longest lived family in the history of the world ate every day of their life. So that's good enough for me.
Yeah, I'm going to start incorporating more beans into my diet because I think that's an excellent source of protein, right?
Cup of beans a day is associated with about 4 extra years of life expectancy.
Yeah. Feeling good. It's about having the years and just feeling good when you're living on Earth, right? As long as you possibly can.
People say, I don't want to live to 100, but actually, the longer you live, the healthier you've been. So if you take a cohort of people, like the Americans who tend to die at 60, they suffer about 8 years of morbidity and disability. Meanwhile, the cohort of people who make it to 100, they're only suffering a year or two of morbidity. So you actually do want to live to 100, and it's within the grasp. Any girl born today in America should be able to make it to age 100.
I love it. My mom's 96, and what you say was absolutely true. She's been in great health for the majority of her life. I love the books that you write, Dan. The Blue Zones, Secrets for Living Longer, Lessons from the Healthiest Places on Earth. It's available in your local bookstore. It's available online everywhere. And where can people reach out to you?
I'm at Dan Buettner on Instagram. I answer my own Instagram. And you know what? I have a free newsletter. I'm a writer for National Geographic, but I write for free at danbuettner.com. You can sign up for that newsletter. And I hope to see you virtually or in person sometime soon.
Dan, it's been great talking to you. Thank you so much for your time.
We'll see you when you're 100.
For sure. Take care. Bye now.